Holy moly, it has been a long time, almost a whole year since I've had biogas up and running. But I can say now, we've got gas. And I've gone from a dude in a shed to a dude under a carport, which is now called the Bio Bunker. And also I'd like to thank everyone that's commented, put suggestions forward, you know, concerned messages. Where are you? Are you still going? You know, thanks very much for keeping on my back and giving me the motivation to keep going. And in that time, we've surpassed 10,000 subscribers, which is amazing. So from the last video that I did, we were just getting ready to set everything up. And I actually went out to a farm, got manure, filled up the digester, put all the stuff in for inoculation, and was letting it sit, ready to start producing gas. But some time went past and there was no gas coming out. I didn't really have time to troubleshoot. Work got chaotic. So I work in insurance repair, so chasing events, doing flood work. Brisbane flooded majorly, Casino, Lismore, all that northern, up the northern coast of New South Wales just went underwater. So for about 6 to 8 months, I was doing work flat out and I just didn't have time to come back and troubleshoot or do anything. But now that's all settled down, I'm on top of it. Last of the paperwork, we're good. You'll have to bear with me here. She's not pretty to look at. But it's a workstation and it's just get up and running at the moment. So first digester, the big 1,000 litre tote. And then we got our 250 litre blue barrel here. So both are up and running. I'm gonna do the original video that I was starting to do before all the floods hit for this one. And then this has actually been inoculated by a method I've never done before. So there'll be a separate video for that one. And we've got new scrubbers compared to those tins I did over there. So there's another video coming of those and actually testing the gas. That's getting full, so we might actually burn that off. All right, I'll just turn this valve off here. Valve off, that stops there. Let's pull this off. Oh yeah. This will be off the methane, just turn it back into carbon dioxide. So this hasn't been scrubbed for anything at the moment, it's just gone through the water. So there's nothing in there but the water. Oh yeah, she's off. Anyway, that's enough to keep that running. Plug it back in. Over there. Valve. So even though it's summer here as well, still got the thermal insulation just to keep the temperature regulated. There is actually aquarium heaters in both of these as well, just to boost it up, because that was the key factor of actually getting gas. And these are powered by solar upstairs. So whilst I do have 8 kilowatts on the roof, I've got a couple extra panels here with battery backup, separate inverters and UPS on there to run downstairs. And that will also run any compressors, anything that I need that is not going to be using power, because one of the main things I had on the compressing videos was, oh, is it really worth it, you know, if you're using grid power to compress this gas? Well, it's all done by solar. And because the last tanks I had were hired, I went out and bought some new ones off marketplace. Well, that almost just covers it for telling you that I'm getting back in the game. So there is exciting things to come. Like I said, the compressing again, we're going to be getting a new compressor. One that's probably a bit more safer and get a few less "you're going to blow yourself up" comments. We've got still the hot water to reinstate that. I've got to do a bit more science on the scrubbing this time and the chemistry behind it. And we'll just try and find some more applications for the biogas. Anyway, guys, you want a kiss? Till next time, and I'll get these other videos up for you with the inoculations. All right, see ya.